There's new hope for answers about what really happened in the search for Ballarat mother Samantha Murphy, with revelations her phone was recovered in near perfect condition. Let's go live to Sarah Jane Bell in Melbourne. Sarah Jane, search crews hope it will lead them to her location.
Shervo, that's right. Detectives are now working with tech experts to try to retrieve the data from Samantha Murphy's phone in the hope it will reveal what happened to the mother of three after she went for a Sunday morning run on February 4. That phone was found nearly a week ago, and now, crucially, as you say, we now know it is in working order, meaning it might be able to help police to track down her body. But we do know that it will be a slow process. Now, the discovery of that phone marked a major breakthrough in this case, a key clue found in the mud of a roadside dam near Buninyong, a town south of Ballarat and not far from where those initial searches took place. Her accused killer, Patrick Stevenson, remains in custody and will return to court in August. But as I say, this is a major development in this case, and it is hoped that this will lead police to Samantha Murphy's body so she can be brought home for a final farewell.
More now on the major development in the case of missing Ballarat mum Samantha Murphy. After the discovery of her phone in recent days, it's now been revealed to 7 News the mobile is in near perfect working condition.
Police have started inspecting the device, and it could end up being sent to international experts to help retrieve extra information from it. The phone is a significant clue which could provide location data for the mother of three's final movements and possibly where her body is. For more, let's bring in criminologists at the University of Newcastle, Dr. Xanthi Mallett. Good morning to you, Xanthi. Is the phone likely to be a game changer for this investigation?
Well, certainly the phone is a major clue in this case. The police were searching for it, obviously, for almost 4 months. Something took them to that dam. That hasn't been disclosed what evidence or intelligence that was yet. But yes, this could absolutely offer new clues that will help find Samantha.
What could be on it that would help them?
Well, as we know now, it is operational and downloadable, and that was my big fear, actually, when we heard that the phone had been found, because 4 months later I was concerned that it would be beyond retrievable in terms of data. But we're looking at possibly better geolocation data, depending on how long the phone was on before the battery died, for example, or it was switched off. It could actually help build that picture of geolocation to help map where that phone moved and potentially, therefore, where Samantha moved.
Given the proximity to the dam, do you think this was dumped early on in this investigation or later?
Well, that's the big question, isn't it? And it's very hard to say, because I would expect a phone that's been underwater or in mud for 4 months to be beyond retrievable. You know, I would have been very surprised that they could have got that phone operational, but yet it is. So does that indicate that it hasn't been there for the entire 4 months? That's yet to be seen. But it's that timeline that the police will be working on, and it's certainly going to be essential in helping to develop that.
OK, so what do police do now?
Well, they're going to be getting as much information from that phone, obviously, as possible. Obviously, building that picture. And I think that there may be potentially more witnesses that may come forward, because we now know about that dam. We know the phone is there. So I'm hoping that now that information is public, other people may come forward and offer information as to who may have dumped that phone and when.
You have to commend the investigators that have worked so hard on this, and you could see the relief and almost celebration. And I know we're not at the end of this investigation yet, but a huge development. Thank you, Xanthi.